everybody and welcome to my YouTube channel. So today I'm going to talk about how to adapt yourself to your step level classes, okay? First of all, you need to know that your students need three essential things. They need to sweat, they need to have fun, and they need to learn, okay? For you to do this, you need to respect two things. First of all, the learning speed or the learning pace, and then the technical level of your classes, okay? When you are going to create class, your beginners or your intermediate or your advanced class, you're going to need to respect these two things, okay? When you're going to do a beginner's class, you need to do a simple technical level and you need to do a slow pace of learning, okay, for your students. Then, what I'm going to do, what that exactly means. It means that you need to do really a technical learning. They need to know your movements, they need to know their repertoire, march, tap, and touch, okay? And you can do a little bit of orientation, so they will learn how to move in space, they will have some basic coordination skills or motor skills, and then they're going to progress, okay? The second level or the intermediate level class is going to be a little bit different, okay? You're going to do an intermediate technical level and intermediate learning speed, okay? So, for instance, you're going to, instead of doing repeaters here, okay, you are going to do there is not going to be any repeaters, okay? There are going to be really easy movements, but there is not going to be as much repeaters as you have in a beginner's class, okay? For instance, here you're going to do a basic step two times, for instance, and here you're going to do just one time, okay? With maybe some difficulties, okay, with arms or other, but it's just going to be addition to what they have learned here. You are going to do intensifications, okay? So you're going to do a little bit more of jumps or putting your hands in the air or really easy stuff with your hands, okay? And you're going to do the transformations. You're going to do didactics like step by step, okay? Where are you going to break down all the movements? So for instance, if you're going to do a three knee repeater, okay, you're going to do then two stomps and then one knee, okay? You're going to learn them how to respect musical accents, how to identify different types of didactics, so they are going to expand their knowledge a little bit, okay? And then you have the third level, the complex advanced level, okay? The learning speed is going to be high and the technical level is going to be really complex, okay? You're going to use a little bit more of style, you're going to use arms, okay, in different ways, symmetrical or asymmetrical. You're going to do different types of didactics, step by step, substitution, insertion, you're going to change your choreography in the middle, you're going to insert some counts, you're going to do the things like the methodologies like extrapolation. So there are things that you can do when you are here that you cannot do here. Okay, many teachers, many of my friends, many of colleagues, even me, I did some mistakes. Okay, my mistakes were that I did a beginner's class, and my learning speed was really sometimes fast, sometimes intermediate, and I had almost every time intermediate technical level, okay? You cannot evolve like this with your students, okay? You're going to lose clients because when you start, you don't have any knowledge of dance, okay? You don't have any knowledge of what is a tap, what is a march, what is a touch, okay? So you need to put yourself in place of a beginner, okay? What can you do as a teacher to facilitate them, sorry, to ease them the choreography, okay? So what can you do? You can, like we said in the other videos, you can be more strategic. You need to do more repeaters. You need to identify the difficult points. You need to, maybe sometimes, even if it's not my case, you can repeat the choreography. For instance, me, I like to change all the time. My choreography needs to change. If I have a course, if I have a class at 10 p.m. And 16 p.m., the same class is not going to be the same techniques, okay? My choreo is going to be different. But that is another thing. So, as a teacher, you need to, sometimes you need to slow down, so sometimes you can accelerate your pace, okay? You need to really respect your students. And that will be something that's going to boost your classes, okay? For instance, you will see, first of all, it was my case to, this year, I started with two persons, okay? I had two students. First of all, they were, they had 50, they were 50 years old. So they thought that step was something that is really fast and that it's not really, it's not adapt for them, okay? Because they were a little bit old and their knees and you know the drill, you know the excuses. So, but when I advanced slowly, they started to be 20, 25, 30 persons. 10 p.m. Okay? So what can you do as a teacher to help them? It's really respect this. Respect this, and you will see you will have many progress in your classes. Okay? So sometimes put yourself in the beginner's position and respect them, okay? And sometimes you can do technical complex levels when you have a high population, high level protection protectionist population, so you can do really difficult things. But as a teacher, think this, okay? Slow and simple. Repeat. And then these people are going to be kicking here and here, okay? But if they don't master the basics, they're never going to kick from here, okay? So if you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe. I want to have 1,000 subscribers until October. I know it's a little bit ambitious, but it is my goal. So if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to contact me via my Facebook or my Snapchat. I will be glad to answer any question that you have. If you have any videos and if you want to share with me your experience, you can leave the comments below. I will be glad to answer you, and I will be glad to speak with you if you want so. Thank you very much, and I will see you soon. Bye bye.